So let's start with the ingredients that we require for this methi muthiya. Now here I've taken about 2 cups of methi leaves, washed them thoroughly and chopped them very fine. Then I have 1.5 teaspoon of ginger paste, 2 teaspoons of green chili paste, 1.5 teaspoon of garlic paste or lasun paste. This is 2 teaspoons of sesame or tir seeds, 1/2 a teaspoon of hing or asafoetida, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric or haldi powder, 2 tablespoons of dahi or curd, 1/2 a cup of chickpea flour or besan, 1.5 tablespoon of sugar, 1.5 cup of wheat flour, some salt to taste, 1 teaspoon of oil for the recipe and the rest of it for deep frying. I will write down all the ingredients along with their measurements in my description box below. Now, if we are going to start by adding the ginger paste to the methi leaves, then goes in the green chili paste, then goes in our garlic paste, now we're going to add salt to taste. I have added about 1.5 teaspoon. Now when you add the salt to the methi starts leaving its own water. So this recipe, if you have noticed, doesn't require any water at all. Now I'm going to be adding the sesame seeds, my asafoetida and my turmeric powder. Again, give all of this a mix so everything gets well incorporated. Now we're going to add our sugar and the yogurt or dahi or curd. And again, we're going to mix all of these ingredients together. So the dahi or the curd and the methi, the water that comes out of the methi leaves once you add the salt, is enough liquid to make these muthiyas. We don't have to add any other liquid except a little bit of oil. So we have to mix all of this very, very well together. Now we're going to add oil. I'm adding about 1.5 tablespoon of oil. And once everything is very well mixed together, we're now going to use our hands because we have to knead this into a dough. So we're going to mix all of this very well with our hands. And now we're going to be adding our besan or chickpea flour. Again, mix it in well. And then goes in our whole wheat flour or chapati flour or wheat flour. And now we're going to mix everything well together. Now, if you find that your dough is really very coarse and you need to add water, only add about 1 tablespoon or 2 tablespoons at the most. Don't add any more water. I did not need to add any water. So if you stick to the measurements, you will not need to add any water to this muthiya dough. Now, as you know, these muthiyas are used to make undiyo. So I'm adding a little bit of oil to make the dough nice and firm. It is used in undiyo, but I'm just making it as a snack because it is really delicious on its own. So I'm just making it as a tea time snack. You can store it in an airtight container for about 2 to 3 days. They still remain nice and crispy. Now, after our dough is formed, we are going to let the dough rest for 10 minutes. Now, after the dough has rested for 10 minutes, we're going to make small little balls like this, flattened, that is mutiyas or croquets. On the side, we can start heating our oil on a very low flame. Now, if we want to keep these mutiyas nice and crispy for a very long time, the key is that our oil has to be heated on a very low flame. Not on a medium flame, not on a high flame. It has to be on a very low flame continuously. Now, once the oil has reached a nice hot temperature, we're going to add the mutiyas. We're not going to overcrowd the pan. And we're not going to touch the mutiyas for at least 2 to 3 minutes because they need to fry well on the low flame. So for at least 5 minutes, let them just fry. This keeps it crispy and it also gives it a longer shelf life. Also, it gets cooked thoroughly or fried thoroughly. And it's not like, you know, if you just fry it on a high fire, only the outside will be golden brown and inside it will still remain raw. Now, after 5 to 10 minutes, you can just turn them around a little and then fry them till they're golden brown. And then once they're done, just take them out on a kitchen napkin. So the key is your flame has to be on a low heat throughout the frying process. Now, in the same way, you can fry all the rest of the mutiyas. These are really very delicious. So our mutiyas are all ready. In fact, they are so delicious that as I was making them, I couldn't resist. I had to have 2 or 3. And I wish I could, show you the sound of the mutiyas. They were so crunchy and so crispy. So I hope you liked this video and this recipe. I hope you give it a try. And if you do, then please leave your comments in the comment box below. Give this video a big like by hitting the like button that you see below this video. I would really appreciate it and get to know that, you know, people do like this recipe. Also, please subscribe to my channel. That would be really so appreciated because I do need the support and I need your encouragement to go on with my channel. So please take the time to log in and subscribe to my channel. It is completely free. Now, once you have subscribed to Akshita's recipes, don't forget to click the golden bell that you will see below the video, because then every time I put up a new recipe on my channel, you will get an email or you will get a message that I have come up with a new recipe, so you can see what is new on Akshita's recipes. Please visit Akshita's recipes. As of today, I have around 230 recipes. All easy, quick, delicious recipes. Please do share my recipes with your family and friends. I would like more and more people to watch my recipes and to enjoy the recipes and try them out and give me their feedback. And if you are looking out for more methi recipes, as of now, I have uploaded a few. I will leave the links of all these recipes in my description box below as well as the comments box. I have methi thepla or parathas, methi malai, plain methi bhaji and methi puris as of today. So I will be coming up with more. But as of now, I have these recipes uploaded on my channel and I will leave the link below. So friends, thank you so much for stopping by and for watching my videos. And I also have started a blog by the name of Akshita's Recipes. I will leave a link in my description box. You can go and check out my blog as well. So thank you once again from the bottom of my heart. And I will catch you in my next video. See you until then and take care.